Hi, in this video from the reported errors feature, I'm going to show you how dates in Blackboard Learn are displayed in an ambiguous way across time zones, and we're going to try to suggest a workaround so that faculty can deal or mitigate this problem. So dates in Blackboard Learn are displayed in three ways when viewed from a time zone different than the server time zone. First, a date might be displayed as time and date without the time zone indicator, and that date means the server time. Second, the date and time are displayed without the time zone indicator, and the time actually means the local time of the end user. And third, the date and time are displayed according to the server time, and there is the time zone indicator, which really is the best way to do this. So let's go ahead and look at this scenario. Right now, we are in the CDT, so Central Daytime time zone, and I'm able to change time zones here on this computer, and we'll be able to see this changing four different displays. Let's go ahead and review this assignment. As an instructor, I'm logging in, and I will verify that the assignment that I am creating is due at 10 p.m. Now, there is no indicator of time zone here, and because I am in the time zone of the server, this is pretty clear, and this is 10 p.m. And I would have an expectation that's what students would see. Now let's go ahead and cancel that, and we will now go ahead and log in as a student, but we are also going to log in here as a student in a different time zone. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll switch our time zone. We'll travel to Warsaw, Poland, and so we are now 6 hours ahead, and so it is already April 16th, 3:34 a.m. All right, let's go ahead and switch to a student user. And now a student user navigates to this assignment. They go ahead and click on the assignment, and what they see here is that the due date is 10 p.m. on April 15th. And so the local time is actually 3:35 a.m. on April 16th. Because there's no server indicator here, there's ambiguity as to can I still submit the assignment or not. Now, this way of displaying dates might be confusing to the student. But when an instructor sees these and then perhaps evaluates whether assignments are late or not, it creates even a more serious environment. But we'll go ahead and submit this. So let's go ahead and press submit. All right. And so now I can see that once I submitted it, here is a date indicated. Again, my date is the 16th. This is the server time date, again, without the indicator for date and time. Now, if I was to switch to announcements, all right, announcements actually do use the time zone indicator. And so that clarifies any difficulties as to understanding what this timestamp really represents. All right, let's move on then as the student to the next section, the discussion. So right now, again, I am looking at displayed time, and this happens to be no time zone indicator, and this happens to be the server time. Now we'll go ahead and go inside of the discussion forum. Now, discussion forum is this a little bit newer product from Blackboard, and so this is done really well in that we have a relative time here, and then as I hover, we have a nice display of our Central Daytime Savings time zone. And so this is again the kind of expectation that we would have to make sure that everyone who is turning in assignments understands that all the days really would be based on server time. All right, we'll now also navigate to the test. And here, as I am navigating into taking the test, notice that the time here is set for April 16 as the due date. Now, April 16th, 3 a.m., right, off the Central Daylight Saving, that's great. Let's go ahead and see what this looks like from instructor perspective. We'll go ahead and exit as the student. All right, and now we are going to navigate to the same assignment, and we'll go here as an instructor. Now, this instructor happens to be in the same time zone in Poland. So, according to the instructor workstation, this is 3:38 a.m. on April 16th. So now we scroll down to the due date, and the instructor gets to pick when this assignment is due. Now, because there is no indicator here, and my date is April 16th, 3:38 a.m., perhaps I want to choose for this assignment to expire in an hour or in about 22 minutes, giving students just a little bit of time to complete it. Of course, if I save this, this is not the time that the instructor intended. As we will see after I switch to the student view, and we now pursue this as a student, right? This got set fine with the time I specified, but it is in the central time zone, which basically means that it's going to be about 6 hours, 30 minutes away from the daytime that the instructor perhaps intended, if the instructor is in another time zone. Okay, let's go to the third scenario, and that is we're going to look at no time zone indicator with the local time displayed. And to show you how this happens, we're going to navigate as a student to a discussion forum. At the same time, I'm going to bring up the Blackboard Mobile system. This is the same course, or we're going to the discussion forum. Okay, so notice now, as we compare these two displays, as we've already learned, Blackboard Learn, when it does not display the time zone indicator, typically it's going to indicate the server time. So this was posted at 7:51 Central, whereas this phone is actually in the Eastern time zone. So right now we're looking at three time zones. The professor's time zone is in Europe, and then the time zone of this student where the phone is located is in the Eastern time zone. And so right now the time zone that is displayed here is the local Eastern time. And so now if I go to navigate inside, all right, I can preview the timestamps. Notice the 8:57 and then 9:05. And as we go in the interface, all right, it's 7:57 instead of 8:57, and it's 8:08. And these properly indicate the time zone, whereas these systems have no time zone indicator, and what's even worse, they show the local time of the end user. So what we are asking is for consistency. Consistency best brought out by including the time zone indicator. And this consistency is going to help instructors to have more confidence in grading assignments. Now, for instructors in this instance, before Blackboard is able to recode the system, the workaround that we're proposing is in the announcement for courses where perhaps the instructor is in a different time zone, or for courses where we have students in different time zones, in the announcement we could post that all due dates, that all time is posted in the Chicago time zone, so the time zone of the server. And this is going to be true for majority of the browser-based product. This is not going to be true for the mobile system, but at least indicating that the time zone is server time zone in the announcement will help to set that expectation.